September 1939, Nazi Germany attack Poland. Two weeks later, Soviet Red Army attack Poland. Soviet Army relentlessly destroys Polish lives, killing thousands, causing the partition of Poland. The Soviets and Germany sign a truce agreement. This resulted into displacement of many Poles from their country.
World War II events have always fascinated me. Stories of disparity and hope, love and hate are countless. This is the story of how Poles traveled all the way from Warsaw to Tehran via the Siberian Gulag.
As you know, the World War II started in 1939 with Germans attacking Poland. And then a little on the 1st of September, and then a little more than 2 weeks later, Soviet Union attacked Poland from the east. And occupied a good portion of Polish lands, and many members of Polish military, doctors, teachers, were then interned or deported by the Soviets. This was in 1939, 1940. A couple hundred thousand people, so that's quite a lot. They were deported to Siberia, to work camps, to concentration camps, to so-called Gulag.
On June 22, 1941, 4.5 million troops of the Axis of Power abruptly launch a blitz attack on the Soviets in an operation codenamed Barbarossa. Fearing a total invasion, the Soviets release and ship a great number of Polish army prisoners and their families to fight in defense of the Soviets. Many of these families made their way to Iran to escape the disasters of war.
Polish life here was very, very vibrant. We had newspapers, clubs, restaurants. And so people were trying to set up their lives, I mean, to live normally. And some of them just, when faced with the question of what to do next, they would choose to stay and to enjoy this normal life in Iran.
Zadowoleni z Iranu zawsze lubi.
I was only 10 at the time. My mother and I made our way to Iran to escape Gulag's pure hell and settled well in the Iranian society. Iran has been wonderful to us, and I am so proud of my mother for enduring so much suffering and bringing me here. I miss her deeply. She is now buried at Tehran's Polish cemetery.
This here is the largest Polish cemetery in Tehran. In it, over 2,400 Poles rest in peace.
Iranians never bothered the immigrants or the Poles. You know how welcoming and hospitable Iranians are. They took us in and shared their food and love with us. We felt right at home, away from the home that did not exist in Poland anymore.
Helena was a darling. Proudly, she showed me her family albums and her pictures of when she was younger in Poland and in Iran. Today, thousands of Polish immigrants to Iran rest in peace at Tehran's largest Polish cemetery.
A Polish philosopher once said that human tragedies are always repeated because future generations easily forget the tragedies that have occurred in previous generations. Amir Rowhoney reporting for Iran.